हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू श्रीमती आर एस कालरिया स्कूल चैनल जूनागढ़। माय नेम इज़ रिधि त्रिवेदी। टुडे विल डू साइंस ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड 7 एनसीईआरटी चैप्टर नंबर 3 फाइबर टू फैब्रिक। बिफोर स्टार्टिंग अ चैप्टर लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड द टर्मिनोलॉजीज रिलेटेड टू दिस टॉपिक। द वेरी फर्स्ट वी हैव फाइबर। नाउ व्हाट इज अ फाइबर? फाइबर मीन्स अ थीन थ्रेड लाइक स्ट्रैंड। Next we have a fabric. Fabric is a material to make clothes. It is a material from which clothes are prepared. The next we have a yarn. Now what is a yarn? A yarn is a continuous strands of fibers. Now students, many a time you have noticed, isn't it? For shopping you go for various occasions. For Diwali, for birthday celebration, for Navratri, for marriage function, isn't it? You go for shopping and you buy varieties of clothes. So you have noticed that some of the clothes are weightless, some of the clothes are hard, some of the clothes are very smooth, isn't it? Lustrous. Some of the clothes are like a woolen type, which also helps in protection of wind. The next we have also the various types of clothes like acrylic, polyester, which is light in weight. So student, from where it is processed, from where we obtain, and how the whole clothes we get. So student, there are two types of fibers. Fibers we obtain from two sources. One from, that is a natural. The next one we obtain artificial. From these two sources we obtain a fiber. Now students, let us understand the characteristics of these two fibers, natural fibers and artificial fibers. Now students, let us understand the natural fibers and artificial fibers. The very first basic, the fibers which is obtained naturally, okay, we can say the fibers obtained naturally from plants, or we can say animals, isn't it? ऐसे फाइबर्स जो हमें प्लांट्स और एनिमल्स से इन अ नेचर, ओके, नेचुरली वी गॉट। तो व्हाट इज दैट एग्जांपल? बाय प्लांट्स वी कैन से कॉटन, जूट, और विथ फ्रॉम एनिमल्स, एनिमल फाइबर्स, तो वी गेट वूल। Wool we get from sheep, yak, etc. Wool yielding animals. Then next example, we get silk in a natural way, isn't it? From silk moths, or we can say silk worms, isn't it? Now the basic characteristic of the natural fiber. While burning a natural fiber, if it smell similar to our hair, then we can say it is a natural fiber. ऐसे फाइबर जिसको आप जलाते हो तो उसकी स्मेल जैसे हमारे बाल जलते हो ऐसी स्मेल आए, तो ये समझना है कि that fiber is a natural fiber. So let us write, while burning it smells similar to human hair burning. उसकी smell similar होती है human hair की burning से. Now next let us see about the artificial. What are the characteristics? So as we understand that natural fibers we obtain from plants and animals, but in this case, in artificial, these fibers which is prepared by man, or we can say even man-made fiber, isn't it? Now let us look the example. What are the example? जैसे ये हमें cotton, jute और wool, silk, ये सभी plants और animals में से पाए जाते हैं. Now from which source we get? Which are the example of these artificial fibers? तो we can say nylon. Nylon के कपड़े देखे हैं ना आपने? Nylon, polyester, acrylic, etc. These are the artificial fibers. Now the next characteristic, as we understand, while burning it smells similar to human hair burning, about natural. But what about the artificial? While burning it smells similar to the burning of plastic. वो नेचुरल फाइबर के या थ्रेड को आप जलाओगे ना, इनमें से कोई नायलॉन, पॉलिएस्टर, एक्रेलिक के पीस में से, तो आपको वो स्मेल कैसी लगेगी? जैसे प्लास्टिक को बर्न करते हो जो स्मेल रिलीज होती है ना, दैट टाइप ऑफ स्मेल यू विल नोटिस इट. सो वी कैन राइट व्हाइल बर्निंग आर्टिफिशियल फाइबर इट स्मेल्स सिमिलर टू burning of plastics. So this is the basic difference between these two fibers, natural fibers and artificial fibers. So these are the points you can generally notice it. So we understand the fibers we obtain from two sources, natural fibers and artificial fibers, isn't it? In the natural fibers, in standard 6, you would understand the fibers which is obtained from plants or animals are called natural fibers. But in this standard 7, this chapter, you will understand the fibers which is obtained from animals. In this chapter, we obtain fibers from animal, that is a wool. Now as we all know, wool is obtained from sheep, yak, goat, isn't it? Llama, alpaca, these all the animals are given in the textbook. So why it is obtained from the sheep, goat or animals? Because their hair, or we can say fleece, are so much growing. Like us humans, our hairs are growing. So we go to barber and cut our hairs. So these, in the same way, these wool yielding animals shear their skin and hair, and which turns into the beautiful garments, isn't it? Now wool, what wool does? Wool traps the air, isn't it? So it gives us protection, it keeps our body warm. Now as we all know, wool is obtained from the sheep, isn't it? So which part is from which part the wool is obtained? Body, or we can say fleece or hair. Now in textbook activity 3.1 is given, feel the hair on your body and arms, isn't it? Have you noticed there are hair in our hands and in our underarms? So the difference between their hair coat. So in the same way, the two types of hairy obtained from the wool. The very first one, the coarse beard hair, the same like our armpit. And second type of wool, or we can say hair, that is the fine soft, which is found in our body, on our hands or legs. The fine soft hair close to skin. This Second category, the fine soft hair close to skin is a fiber from which a fabric is prepared. Now, which helps in making wool. Now, students, as we know that this type of hairs, we have noticed that both our body parts are different in touch, isn't it? So, to obtain a such good quality of the wool, their parents are specially chosen to give birth of such kinds of category of the wool. That process, okay, for selecting the fine hair close to the skin, their parents are specially chosen. That process are known as a selective breeding. This process is called a selective breeding. So this coarse beard hair, which is also useful for various other purposes, but the second category, the fine soft hair, are obtained from such good quality of the sheep's wool, and that process are called selective breeding. For that, the special type parents are chosen to give a special type of wool yielding animals. Learn about the animals that yields wool. Yak wool, which is popular or common in Tibet and Ladakh. Mohair wool, which is obtained from Angora goat, which is found in Jammu and Kashmir. The next is Kashmiri goat wool, now which is woven into fine shawls, as Angora goat, Kashmiri goats woven into fine pashmina shawls. Their wool is soft. You have noticed this type of shawl at your home. The next, llama and alpaca are also animals which is found in South America, which yields a wool. In the textbook, activity 3.2 is given. Now, what is this activity? You have to collect the pictures of these of the animals and you have to paste it in a scrapbook. And also, you have to find the words of sheep, goat, camel, yak in our local regional language. So this will make your more learning interesting. Now the next activity 3.3 we are having, procure outline map of India and the world. Now you have to take the map. Now what you have to do? Find out and mark the places on the map where you found this type of wool yielding animals with the different colors, with their location, which yields a wool. As we all know, for obtaining wool, sheep are reared. So let us move to the next topic, rearing and breeding of sheep. We all know, for obtaining wool, sheep are reared. Apart from grazing, you have noticed shepherds or cattle rearers took their herd of sheep for grazing activities, isn't it? For a part of grazing, sheep are reared also, feed on them the mixture of pulses, corn, jowar, oil cakes. Now what is a oil cakes? It is a material left after taking oil from the seeds. We have na such types of seeds. For example, groundnut, cotton, mustard, isn't it? Some of the left of the oil cakes from which the oil is taken out and their seeds are given to the sheep for their food. In winter, sheep are kept indoors. Why? Because to protect from cold, isn't it? To protect from the cold, and fed on leaves, dry fodders and grains. Dry fodder, sukha ghas, isn't it? So in this way, sheep are reared. And the breeding of sheep, in which the sheep obtain a good quality of the hair, and as a time their hair grows and the hairs are sheared out, isn't it? In table 3.1 we'll understand some of the breeds, Indian breeds of the sheep. So let us look to the table which is given in the textbook 3.1. According to table 3.1, we have some of the Indian breeds of sheep. The very first breed is Lohi. Now Lohi gives a good quality of the wool which is found in the state of Rajasthan and Punjab. The next breed we are having Rampur Bashir. Okay, Rampur Bashir gives a brown fleece wool. As we all know, the fleece of sheep have three colors: black, white, and brown. So the Rampur Bashir have a brown fleece wool, which is found in the state of Uttar Pradesh and Himachal Pradesh. The next breed we have a Nalli breed, which is used for carpet wool. Okay, and it is found in Rajasthan, Punjab, Haryana. The next is Bakharwal, which is woven into woolen shawl, Bakharwal shawl. आपने घर पे होगा बोलना, आपने मदर को दिखाए Bakharwal shawl. Okay, so Bakharwal is a breed which is good quality of wool into a woven into a woolen shawl, and it is found in the state of Jammu and Kashmir. The next we are having Marwari breed, which is gives a coarse wool, rough wool we can say. Generally it is used for the doormats, carpets, isn't it? And it is found in the Gujarat state. The next and last we are having a Patanwadi breed, which is used for hosiery. Now here hosiery, we can say socks, hand gloves, leggings, small infant's clothes, isn't it? So Patanwadi breed gives use for hosiery, and it is found in Gujarat state. The sheep are reared, they develop into a long hairs. Okay, so their hairs are get shaved off for getting wool. Now let us understand the processing fibers into wool. Now in this process we goes to the various step. As we know that woolen clothes we wear is not come from the direct fleece of the hair and it is yarn. It goes through the various steps. So let us understand this each step. The very first step, shearing. Now what is the shearing? The fleece of the sheep along with the thin layer of the skin is removed from the body, is known as a shearing. Now shearing does not hurt a sheep. You question arise, okay, why? The same way when you go for haircuts to barber to cut your hairs, did it hurt you? No. In the same way sheep doesn't hurt by the shearing process, because the uppermost layer of the skin is dead, and in the same like us they grows hair, and after a time their skin is sheared. Okay, the next step is scouring. Once the fleece of the sheep is sheared, they send to the next step, that is a scouring. Now what happens in the scouring? The sheared skin with the hair is thoroughly washed in a tank. यहाँ पे टैंक में सारी इम्प्योरिटीज को निकालते हैं. किस किस तरह की इम्प्योरिटीज होती है? विच टाइप ऑफ इम्प्योरिटीज आर फाउंड? लाइक ग्रीस, डस्ट, डर्ट. नाउ क्वेश्चन अराइज कि व्हाट इज ग्रीस? नाउ ग्रीस इज अ मटेरियल. ओके, इट इज अ सब्सटेंस सीक्रेटेड फ्रॉम द सीबेकियस ग्लैंड विच प्रोड्यूस फ्रॉम द स्वेट ग्लैंड. जैसे हमारी बॉडी में स्वेट की ग्लैंड होती है ना, वैसे ही सीबेसियस ग्लैंड विच गिव्स प्रोड्यूस द स्वेट ग्लैंड. सो यहाँ पे सारी इम्प्योरिटीज निकाल देते हैं. द इन टैंक इट इज वॉश्ड शियर स्किन. ओके, नाउडेज द मशीन, स्पेशल मशीन्स आर देयर फॉर शियरिंग एंड स्कोरिंग पर्पज. द नेक्स्ट स्टेप दैट इज अ सॉर्टिंग. वंस द skin is sheared, scored, the next step is sorting. Now what does in sorting? In sorting the hair is skin is sent to a factory where the hair of different texture, isn't it? Humne aage bhi dekha na ke sabhi texture alag hota hai, like the hair in our hands and in our armpits, both are totally different, so their textures are separated, or we can say sorted in this sorting process. The next, after the sorting, okay, the after the sorting, the next step, that is a cleaning or removing of burrs. What is a burrs? Now, burrs is a small fibers, fluffy fibers, which is generally you have noticed on your sweaters. During winter season you wear na, you will see small burrs. Aap usko aise kheech ke nikal lete ho na, that is a burrs, okay? The small fluffy fibers called burrs are picked out from the hair. Now, these are the same burrs which is found on your sweaters, and it is are squared again and dried. This is wool ready to drawn into a fiber from this stage. Now the wool is ready to drawn into a yarn. Now next step, number 5, is the dyeing. Now dyeing means gives a color, okay? As we all know, the fleece of sheep has only 3 colors, black, white and gray. But we see beautiful colors, okay, in a sweaters, blankets, jackets, isn't it? Beautiful colors. So from where it is come, these are dyed into beautiful colors. The fibers can be dyed into various colors as natural fleece of sheep have black, white and gray. Next step, that is a 6th step. Now the after the dyeing, the fibers are rolled. Now here what happens, the long fibers are yarned into a long sweaters, blankets, shawls, isn't it? And small fibers are combed into a cloths. So we can say the fibers are straightened, combed and rolled into yarn, and the longer fibers are made into wool for sweaters, blankets, etc., and the shorter ones are woven into woolen cloths. So this is the process about fiber into a wool. The first step is shearing, scoring, sorting, cleaning or removal of burrs, dyeing and rolling. Now student, in our textbook one fact is given about a occupational hazard. We all know wool industry is an important livelihood in our country. So many people depend on this industry. But sorter's job in this process, sorter's job, this sorting process is called a sorter's job. This process, sorter's job, is risky at time because they get infected by a bacterium called anthrax. Now what does this bacteria does? This bacteria causes a fatal blood disease called sorter's disease, okay? Such risk factors by workers in any industry, which is also called the occupational hazard. So this process, nowadays machines are there, this process totally done into machine, but before that the person who involved in this process, in the third step, that is a sorting job, sorter's job, is risky because it may affected with the anthrax bacteria. Like you all, Bujo in our textbook is also wondering, is curious to ask a question. In textbook page number 28 we have a question that Bujo is wondering why it hurts when someone pulls his hair but not when he goes for a haircut. Bujo ka kya question hai? Bujo is questioning that jab koi hamare baal khichta hai to hame dard hota hai, but when we go for haircut, barber के पास जाके हम बाल कटवाते तो हमें क्यों दर्द नहीं होता है? You all are curious about this answer, right? Like this Bujo. Here is your answer, students. Because the hair is made up of dead cell. Okay? So if we cut the hair, we go not harm. But the scalp on which the hairs are rooted are living cell. So if we picks up or we pluck it, hurts because the cells present in the scalp are living cells. Okay, so for the sheep also the shearings does not get harm. The next question Bujo is asking, that he is wondering why a cotton garment cannot keep us warm in winter as woolen sweater does. Woolen sweaters ki tarah winter mein cotton kyun nahi kaam deta hai? Here the answer, clothes cut off. Cotton clothes are the thin, विच डज नॉट हैव स्पेसिस इन देयर फैब्रिक टू ट्रैप एयर, उसके फैब्रिक में ऐसी स्पेस नहीं होती है कि वो एयर को ट्रैप कर सके, पकड़ सके. ओके, सो इट विल नॉट कीप अस वार्म एज कंपेयर टू वुलन क्लॉथ, बिकॉज वुलन क्लॉथ ट्रैप्स द एयर एंड इट कीप्स अवर बॉडी वार्म. सो स्टूडेंट्स, हियर वी एंड विद द एनिमल फाइबर दैट इज ऑब्टेन्ड फ्रॉम द शीप. विच फाइबर वी ऑब्टेन्ड फ्रॉम द शीप? गॉट yet that is a wool. Now let us start with the next animal fiber which is obtained from animal. Now the fiber is silk which is obtained from silk moth. Then silk fibers are also animal fibers. Okay, we understand about the wool which is obtained from various animals like goat, sheep, yak, isn't it? Like the same way, silk fibers are also animal fibers. Silkworms spin the silk fibers. Okay, wools are sheared from the fleece of the animals, wool yielding animals. Here silkworm spins the silk fiber. Silkworm hai na, wo silk fiber banata hai. The rearing of silkworms for obtaining silk is called a sericulture. Okay, the rearing of silkworms, the silkworms are reared for obtaining silk, that known as sericulture. Now before starting the process how it is obtained, I would like to tell a very interesting story, or we can say fact about a silk. We all know that China leads the world, okay, in silk production, okay, after India. So discovery of silk, here in the textbook is given, okay, the exact time of discovery of silk is perhaps unknown, which is not knowing. According to an old Chinese legend, an empress, Sai Lung Chei, was asked by an emperor, Hong Tai, to find the cause on the damaged leaves of the mulberry trees growing in their garden. Usne emperors ko pucha ke what are the cause, okay, which are having a cause to a mulberry leaves. The empress found various white worms eating up mulberry leaves. Usne dekha ke kitni sari worms hai wo white color ki hai, wo mulberry leaves ko khate hai. Okay, she also noticed that they were spinning shiny cocoons around them. Accidentally, a cocoon dropped into a hot cup of tea, which is tangled and delicate thread is separated from the cocoon. So, silk industry began in China, and China was kept closely guarded सीक्रेट फॉर 100 ईयर्स. चाइना ने हमसे ये फैक्ट छुपा के रखी है, ओके, फॉर 100 ऑफ ईयर्स. लेटर ऑन ट्रेडर्स एंड ट्रेवलर्स इंट्रोड्यूस्ड सिल्क टू अदर कंट्रीज, सो द रूट दे ट्रेवल्ड इज स्टिल कॉल्ड अ सिल्क रूट. सो दिस इज अ फैक्ट, ओके, अबाउट द प्रोडक्शन ऑफ सिल्क. नाउ लेट अस मूव टू द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक. So let us start with the life history of a silk moth. In the life history of a silk moth, it passes through these four stages. So let us understand the very first stage. The first stage, in that female silk moth lays eggs on mulberry leaves. Okay, female silk moth lays eggs on a mulberry leaves. Now after the first stage, when they lays their eggs, the next stage is number 2, larva, that is incubated eggs hatched out. Larvae is called caterpillar or silkworm. It stops eating mulberry leaves up to 25 to 30 days. Okay, up to 25 to 30 days tak wo khate rehte hain. They grow in size enormously, and after it stops eating mulberry leaves up to 25-30 days and become dormant, inactive. फिर बाद में वो inactive हो जाते हैं. After the second stage, it moves to the third stage, that is a pupa. In that, caterpillar weaves a net to hold itself. वो एक अपने जैसे जाली जैसा बनाते हैं जिसमें वो अपने आप को पकड़ के रखे, होल्ड कर लेते हैं. इट स्विंग्स इट हेड इन द फिगर एट. जैसे हम एट ऐसे लिखते हैं ना, इस तरह से वो अपने फिगर, इस शेप में वो अपने हेड को मूव करते हैं. नाउ व्हाट हैपेंस ड्यूरिंग दिस मोमेंट, नाउ दिस मोमेंट मीन्स व्हेन दे आर मूविंग देयर हेड इन द फॉर्म और पैटर्न ऑफ एट. ड्यूरिंग दिस मोमेंट कैटरपिलर सीक्रेट्स ऑफ फाइबर, वो वहाँ पे एक फाइबर बनाता है विच इज मेड अप ऑफ प्रोटीन्स, ओके, एंड इट इज हार्डन इवन ऑन एक्सपोजर टू एयर. हियर इट इज कम्प्लीटली कवर्स बाय सिल्क फाइबर्स, वो यहाँ पे वो सिल्क फाइबर से कम्प्लीटली कवर हो जाता है विच इज कॉल्ड अ ककून. एंड आफ्टर दैट थर्ड स्टेज इन फोर्थ द सिल्क मोथ कम्स आउट बाय ब्रेकिंग ककून. Isn't it? हमने स्टोरी में देखा था ना कि वो ककून जैसा कवरिंग था वो गर्म चाय में गिरा. Isn't it? We had seen that cocoon dropped into a hot tea and the fiber is secreted. So here the silk moth comes out by the breaking out the cocoon. So this is the life history of a silk moth in which it passes through the four stages, that is eggs, larvae, pupa, and which is completely breaks out from the cocoon. So students, as we understand that silk thread is obtained from the cocoon of the silk moth. Now there is a variety of silk, okay, there is a variety of silk moths which looks very different from one another, and the silk thread, their yield is different in texture, isn't it? Uska texture alag hota hai. For example, we can say coarse, smooth, shiny, lustrous, isn't it? And we have various types of silk. The names are tusher silk, muga silk, kosha silk, isn't it? Which are obtained from the cocoons spun by different types of moths. The moths, common silk moth is a very common. It is a very common silk moth. We can say a mulberry silk moth. The silk fiber from the cocoon of mulberry silk moth is lustrous and elastic in nature and can be dyed into beautiful colors, isn't it? Now, sericulture or culture of silkworm is a very old occupation in India, as I told you in the first, isn't it? Now, in the textbook, according to textbook activities, we are having 3.5, 3.6 and 3.7. Now, let us look what these activities says. These activities are interesting, you can do it. Collect the pieces of the silk cloth of various types, okay, and paste them into your scrapbook. You can collect this from the tailor shop, from the heap of the waste cloth. Even you tell your mom, okay, if you are having such types of waste, you can also cut and paste the pictures. Now, so you can fill, through these activities, you can fill that different types of silk have a different in touch. The activity 3.6. Now what you have to do, take a synthetic silk thread, artificial, which we had understand na, and a pure silk thread. Now you have to burn these both threads. So what you will notice, as we understood in the earlier, the characteristic, okay, any difference you find while burning? Yes, while burning both the threads, the smells comes out different. Now what is that? Okay, smell like hair while burning is a pure silk, and smell like paper or plastic is an artificial silk. The next activity 3.7, you have to cut the pictures of the stages of the life history of a silk moth, and you have to jumble it, paste in a jumbled way, and then you have to give the numbers, rearrange themselves in a cyclic form, so you can easily recall that life history of a silk moth. So now we'll understand from cocoon to silk, isn't it? We'll understand the journey from cocoon to silk. The very first rearing of a silkworms, how the silkworms are reared for obtaining silk. The eggs are stored poured carefully on the strips of clothes or paper and sold it to a silkworm's farmers. Okay, the person who associated with this business, this sold it. Okay, and this business is also known as a sericulture. These eggs are kept under a hygienic condition or in a suitable temperature. Okay, the eggs ko jo temperature chahiye, according to that they store. Okay, suitable temperature and humidity. This is done when mulberry trees bear a fresh crop of leaves, because they eat. Okay, they eat these leaves. They eat days and night in increase in size enormously. वो दिन रात खाते ही रहते हैं और अपनी साइज को बढ़ा देते हैं. The larva kept in a bamboo trays along with the mulberry leaves. When they stop eating it, it moves to a tiny chambers of bamboo which spins a cocoon, and inside that tray they made a silk fiber. After the rearing of the silkworm, now we'll understand the process of silk, how the silk is processing. So first of all, a pile of cocoons is used for obtaining silk fibers. We had understand from the that the piles of cocoons are used for obtaining silk. The cocoons are kept under the sun or boiled or exposed to the steam, and the silk fibers is then separated out. The process of taking out threads from the cocoon for the use of silk is known as reeling of silk. Nowadays the reeling is done in a special machines in which unwinds the threads that from the cocoons, and the silk fibers are spun from the cocoons and woven into silk clothes by a weavers. So in this way the silk cloth is prepared, we obtain silk. Here we end our chapter. I hope you understand it. Thank you.